Hello, my friend, this is Mikhail. You know, I like music. I wanted to be a musician once, but when I asked my mom to buy me a balalaika, she said, "What balalaika, Mikhail? Your fingers are too short and too fat. You will not be able to play anything." I don't believe that. But to check it, I need a balalaika. So today, I'm going to show you how to turn this into this. Come on, let's go.
Okay, so let me explain a little bit about how and why. You see, a common balalaika has three angles, but they are very sharp and look kinda hippie-ish. So what we're gonna do, we are going to build a balalaika that has four angles, and it will be electric one. So first of all, we need to get some wood. Let's see, this one is too curvy. Well, my dad's gonna kill me if I use this one. This one, it's split, it's beautiful, it's perfect. Okay, let's use it. Now, we need to cut it to length. For this operation, I'm gonna use a simple handsaw. Ooh, it cuts really good. After cutting right length, you need to cut to right width also, to make sure that your plank will be perfectly square. Okay, we're almost there, we need just a little bit more. Years ago, Italian Michelangelo made his sculpture David, and now Mikhail made the plank. How do you like it, my friends? Well, it needs some trimming after all. Let's do that. Okay, now we need some wiener. The wood wiener, not the sosiska. Now we need to take measurements for the body of balalaika. Make sure measurements are correct, because once you cut it, there's no way back, remember that. Do you remember when I told you that there is no way back? Well, actually there is. And now, because I cut it so poorly, I'm gonna show you that way. We just need to clamp it and... Wiener itself is very thin, so we add some supporting pegs, so the final box would be a little bit stronger. Okay, let's apply glue, but make sure you do not apply too much glue, because otherwise you will have a mess. You need just the right amount of glue. When glue dries out, make some error corrections if necessary. Now it's time to glue the sides of balalaika, and once again, don't use too much glue, because otherwise it will stuck to your board and you will not be able to get it off. Of course, use some clamps to make the joints stronger. Use a second clamp if you feel need to. Make some error correction if necessary. The exact same principle applies to other two sides of the balalaika box. If it doesn't fit as planned, no worry. We will make some error corrections on the way when it will dry out. Now just glue it. Of course, use the clamp also. Check if it's straight and add in spacer. Now we need to make some cutouts for the neck of balalaika. Now let's do the same for the neck of balalaika. Take some measurements and, well, my electric saw is not long enough to make the cutout for the neck, so I had to use manual saw. But it turned out okay, as you can see. That's a nice long neck. Of course, I am too cheap to use normal commercial tuners for the guitar or balalaika, so I will make my own tuner. And it will work, well, some kind of like this. Push and pull. Time to shape up the neck. It turned out nice, really nice, quite comfortable, I'd say. Okay, so let's set the tuner already. You need to pre-drill some pilot holes for your screws, so they wouldn't split your piece of wood. After that, we will just add some corner piece that we make ourselves, because we are too cheap, once more. One screw, two screws, oh yeah, everything is perfect. Let's check how it works. Pull, push, pull, push. Okay, it's a beauty. Let's electrify this baby. We will need a guitar jack, a piezoelectric element, and some soldering skills. You want to use microphone wire just for the better shielding, and then just glue the piezo element using epoxy to the inside of your balalaika box. And keep it tight in case you accidentally break it in front of a lot of people. Now, using the Glazomera precision, mark the dimensions of your front blades and cut them. Does it fit? Well, not yet, but soon it will. Okay, let's try it now. How do you fit now? Well, it fits a lot better this time, and the exact same procedure goes to the other side of the front plate. You're not little kids, you can figure it out on your own, right? Okay, but front plates will need some support peg too. Now carefully apply glue to the support pegs and use a piece of wiener to determine the height we should be in. It could be, well, hard at first, but no worries, you will get it. Do the same procedure for as many support pegs as you like. In general, more is better, but I like to go cheap and leave a lot of space between them. Yeah, I told you not to use too much glue. Okay, let's forget about that. Now do the same procedure for the neck of the balalaika. Of course, be extremely careful. And when it's set, check once more if everything fits right. Well, if it's not, make some error correction. But wait, we need a sound hole. Okay, it's time to glue the balalaika up once everything is ready. Apply a little bit of glue. Hey, what's that? I said a little bit. Oh. Okay, hold on. Let me clean that up. Let's carefully place the neck into body and... Okay, a little bit of force, everything's fine. Add in some more glue if you feel need to. Now glue the front plates also. And hopefully they will fit in place. If not, you know what to do. But in my case, everything fits nicely. So, I just push it in. I said nicely, come on. Okay, everything seems perfect. Now let's put a little bit of pressure. Keep it under pressure so it wouldn't fall apart, and do the same for the other front plate. Now add some weight. When balalaika is drying up, let's make a saddle and nut for it. Oi, blin! Oh, I'm okay, but I won't have to cut my nails for a week. Maybe I should start a business and open my own manicure studio. And the brand would be Mikhail Gel Nail Polish. Cool, don't you think? Okay, enough about nails. After gluing bolt and bridge into place, it's time to mark some fret marks. There are plenty calculators online, so I will not explain you how exactly I measured my fret marks. But after you measure it, run through them with your triangle mini file. That will make a little grooves, like a pilot grooves. After it, just run again with your broken round file.
Hello, Mikhail, what are you doing?
I'm making a balalaika, blin.
Ha, you silly, this balalaika is too long. You will not be able to tune it, you will break all your strings. Believe me.
I probably needed to check this before. Ой, блин! told that I can fix anything. And now it's time to make the threads. I used nails, you could use any piece of straight wire-like material. Let's mix some epoxy glue to glue them in place. This is the time when you really shouldn't put much glue, because otherwise your balalaika will look dirty. Gluing itself is very simple, just lay them inside their places that you have made earlier. Oh, wow, look at that, I'm so fast with these threads. Okay, now just make sure that you do not leave any unwanted glue. Ha, it's sparking, I bet that's how Chernobyl fire started. When you made sure that your threads isn't cutting anybody's fingers, it's time to put a coating. I chose to put a linseed oil coating, not because it's biodegradable or that I'm an environmentalist, but because I had it on my hand. Just rub it in and then wipe off any excess. Just look how it emphasizes the color of wood. When coating hardens, you need to string it. I will use common fishing line for E and steel wire for A. Let's tune it and go play.
So there you have it, a balalaika. Now let's check out how it plays. So that's for this video today. If you want to see me doing something Eastern European style, then comment below. And as always, like, share and subscribe. And keep on chicken breaking, my friends.